I want to read a few more verses from John chapter 1. John chapter 1 verses 31 to 37. This is John the Baptist speaking. And I knew him not, speaking of the Lord Jesus Christ, but that he should be made manifest to Israel. Therefore am I come baptizing with water. And John bore record, saying, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it abode upon him. And I knew him not, but he that sent me to baptize with water, the same said unto me, Upon whom thou shalt see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, the same is he which baptizeth with the Holy Spirit. And I saw and bear record that this is the Son of God. Again the next day after, John stood and two of his disciples, and looking upon Jesus as he walked, he said, Behold, the Lamb of God. And the two disciples heard him speak, and they followed Jesus. You see, the Lord Jesus Christ wants disciples. Yes, he wants Christians. Now, Christians are those who have been saved by the grace of God through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. I believe what he's really looking for is disciples, because they are the people that have dedicated their lives, as it were, to the Lord Jesus Christ, because they've been bought with a price. And it says in the Word of God, therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. And that is because a child of God, when we are born again into God's family, we become children of God. Now that's what God wants for you this afternoon. That you might know the new birth, that you might be born from above. You might be born by the Spirit of the living God through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. You see, God is not our Father, contrary to the thoughts of many people. Oh, we're God's children. No, we're not. We need to be born again into God's family through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ came not only to live the perfect life on earth, but the real purpose which he came for, that was to display that he's the perfect Son of the living God, in thought, word, and deed, never sinned. It's impossible for the Lord Jesus Christ to sin. But not only that, then he died upon the cross of Calvary to bring us back to God, to make the way open that you and I could be saved by the grace of God through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. You see, if you don't trust the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, you'll be in hell when you die. It's as simple as that. God does not want that. He's not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. He wants us to agree with him that we are sinners. That's what repentance is. It's a change of mind. Coming to God and agreeing with him that I'm a sinner. And then having established that, then we need to come and put our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That can be yours this afternoon. As you listen to this message, the work has been done on the cross of Calvary. The Lord Jesus Christ has died upon the cross, shed his precious sinless blood, went into death, yes, he was buried, but praise God, the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures. He's a living, loving Savior who desires that your soul might be saved right now, this afternoon. You can be saved by the grace of God through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. Don't miss out on God's eternal salvation. And don't let anyone trick you saying that you can lose your salvation. You can't, because it's the life of the very God of heaven, and he will exist forever. He has existed in eternity past, and he will go on forever in eternity. You and I do not need to face the judgment of God. The Lord Jesus Christ has gone into that judgment and faced the judgment for you and for me. He's taken the place of us as sinners. He's the divine substitute and he paid for the sins of all those who will put their faith in him. Come this afternoon in repentance and faith. Just acknowledge you're a sinner before God, and then believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved.